Hello? Is it fine? Okay. So Adam is working as an associate in an investment banking firm in Mumbai, whereas Eve has just started her 2-year management program from a B school in India. They both are in a relationship from 3 years and understand each other really well. There may be Adam and Eve, but like most relations, they are hitting a rough patch. They hardly get time to talk to each other or even meet. Somehow, they survive the 2 years. Eve has been hired by a consultancy firm and has a lot of work to do since the day one. After 2 years, they decide to start over again and keep their differences aside. They take a flat in rent and start living together. But the problem is still there in the paradise. They fight over the little things as who will do the chores, who will handle the finances, or how they will handle the finances, or even who will pay the bill of the dinner, as Adam always insisted he will pay the bill. There was always a competition as who is more busier, whose work is more relevant. Slowly and slowly, the relationship start breaking, and they decided to go their separate ways. Our Adam and Eve were not together anymore. As they say, you realize the value of something when you lose it. Adam and Eve started realizing the beauty of their relationship. They realized that while they were together, they hardly apologized to each other. They were never complimenting each other. Adam could not recall the last time he complimented Eve for how beautiful she looked, or Eve could not remember the last time she expressed her love for Adam. Maybe all they needed was 3 magical words and a hug at the end of the day. All they needed was to listen to each other patiently. Adam and Eve were not used to the failing, and this time they were not going to fail in their relationship. Their love and longing for each other brought them together again. They decided to give each other another chance, a new inning. And this time as well, they did have differences, but they decided to work on them together and strengthen their relationship. Now, if we look at the problem Adam and Eve had, who was responsible? Was it Adam or was it Eve? Or was it the factors that were affecting the relationship? The power, the time, the gravity, or the love? Let's dig more into these points and see what went wrong.
Was it Eve who started focusing more on her job and changed her priorities? Or was it Adams who had become more goal-centric and workaholic? Well, it was neither. The invisible force that started all this menace was time. Yes. Time, my friend, is a rare and precious commodity that is priced above all. However, Eve and Adam wanted to be together and wanted their relationship to work out, it was not happening. They thought they would manage, but things were not working out. They did all the efforts of coming closer, living in the same apartment, but they were miles apart. Whatever they did or they wanted to do, they first had to check with their invisible master whether they had the time to do all these things or not. They tried hard of doing all these things and move on to the train full of happiness, but it seemed that they were always late to board that train. So many of you might be thinking that, no, it's not the time. Somebody, Eve or Adams, might be at the fault at their behavior level. But if you dig deeper and think a little bit, it was the only factor that was causing all this menace. We have known time to be rare and precious. We all have. But never have we ever thought that time would decide and dictate our terms in future. It has become so powerful that we all humans have been shackled in the chains of anxiety and stressfulness. I just want to leave you all with this small thought, and you must be knowing from the story of Adam and Eve, if they could have just spent 5 minutes, 15 minutes together of quality time, this whole thing of breaking apart would not have happened in the first place. That's all.
Now that we've seen how time impacts a romantic relationship, let's look at gravity. So what is gravity? It is one of the universal forces that distorts time, bends light, and shapes the very fabric of reality. Well, it got me thinking that if gravity influences all matter in the universe, how is it that it affects romantic relationships? So let's get back to the definition of gravity. But Newton's gravitational law of Newton's law of universal gravitation says that every particle attracts every other particle with a force which varies inversely with the square of distance. Now, for all the non-engineers here, I would like to give a simpler definition. So, a force that attracts a body towards itself, which has mass. Now, what it essentially says that every particle affects every other particle in the universe relative to its mass. And this force diminishes as the distance between the particles increases. When the distance is close, the gravitational pull is very strong. But as the distance increases, the gravitational force also reduces. Doesn't it sound similar to a long-distance relationship? And well, how is it different from, you know, the sun and the earth, our scientific gravity? Well, we have our interests, our experiences, our morals, our values, our life choices. These are the things that create a peculiar gravitational pull around on the people that surround us. And this is easily visible if you observe the impact that these things have on your loved ones and near and dear ones. And isn't this what happens with Adam and Eve too? I mean, they've got used to each other. They've known each other for 3 years. And they've grown into each other. They've got used to set patterns. They would do certain things together as a ritual. And now all of a sudden it's gone. And there's a distance which is created. And the gravitational pull, the gravity that we're talking about between them, has really gone down to some extent, or to a very large extent for that matter. And maybe if you guys are still not convinced about gravity, why is it that we fall in love, right? Gravity makes us fall in love and not, you know, maybe anything else. That is why we fall in love. So this said, after Eve gets placed and she started working for a consulting firm, they're back together in Bombay and they're living together. They're as close to each other as they can be. So in theory, with all that I've said, life should be back to fine again, right? They're close to each other. The gravity is as strong as possible. So what is it that again creates some kind of, you know, disturbance in their relationships and in their relationship? And what is it that is exactly troubling them? I would like to call upon Manish to talk on this further.
Yes, so as Chiranjeev likely said, now that they are together, the forces of gravity and time should have certainly diminished. So what is that is still existing and causing the difference? The force that has now emerged and is causing the difference is nothing but power. But what is power? Power is the way we relate to each other. It is the basic force that drives our social interaction. It dictates whether you get listened to. It determines whether your needs or priority gets any attention, does it get any attention or not. Power is not just limited to leaders or organizations. It doesn't require any outright acts of dominance. For romantic partners, power is something that is a prime force that affects them. It blunts their sensitivity to another partner and precludes emotional connectivity. It is the major barrier to intimacy for those romantic partners. The ability of couples to withstand stress, respond to change, and enhance each other's well-being depends on their having a really good balance of power in between them. If you have power in a relationship, you have an effect on your partner due to your emotions. That's a good sign for the long-term stability in between those partners and happiness in between them. But for some, it might be an emotional burden as the inertia of emotionness in them is too high. Relationally, if one partner wins, the other loses. But in this case, both of them lose because the winner has to pay the loser. The balance of power in a relationship is built on equality and affects individual and relationships' well-being. It fosters mutual responsiveness in between them. It determines whether you'll be satisfied or have days spiked with resentment and depression. Each partner has a positive regard for the humanity of the other and sees the other as admirable, worthy of kindness in a considerate and collaborative relationship. Conflicts may occur and negativity may escalate quickly, but partners who make deliberate efforts to be with each other again is what is the driver behind that balance of power. They follow up by replacing defensiveness with listening to the other's position. Both partners foster the well-being of the other physically, emotionally, and financially. I would like to end this by saying that balance of power, although it seems very difficult to attain, it's not impossible. This force that I spoke about, along with another force that I would like Abhinav to come and speak about, is what is the primary thing that affects romantic relationships. I would like to now hand it over to Abhinav.
Okay, love. I think at some point of time, we all have read about, wrote about, or even experienced love in so many different forms. And that's why a lot of people have tried to define love in so many different ways. So what's new today? We talked about gravity, we talked about time, and we talked about power. So let's dig a little deeper there. Perhaps you've read about it. I'm talking about Einstein's letter to his controversial letter to his daughter, offering a universal message behind the powerful force of love. It's a beautiful read. It offers a universal message that speaks to the essence of human condition and our incessant yearning to believe in the conquering force of love. Now, when I think about it, you know, those sentiments being conveyed by such a revolutionary scientist, It only solidifies its potence and widespread appeal. He said, and I quote, "When I proposed the theory of relativity, very few could believe me. And what I'm going to transmit now to the human mankind, maybe that will collide with the misunderstanding and the prejudice that is prevailing in the world right now. There's a powerful force that scientists have not found a formal explanation to. The force that includes and governs almost everything. That force is a universal force of love. Love is a light that enlightens those who give and receive it. Love is gravity because it makes feel someone attracted to the some other person. Love is power because it multiplies the best we have and allows humanity not to be extinguished by the blind selfishness. It reveals and unfolds. So what's next? I would say if we want our humanity to survive, if we want to find the real meaning of life, love is the only answer. Perhaps we cannot build a super bomb of love, you know, that will destroy all the selfishness and the hate that is prevailing in the world. But we have a solution. Every individual of us is carrying within themselves a small generator of love, the energy of whose is waiting to be released. And once we have released this energy, we'll be affirmed that love is the conquering force. And it transcends almost everything and anything in this world. Because love is the quintessence of life. And this quintessence of life brought Adam and Eve together. Thank you.
Questions? Remember, you'd be also evaluated by the quality of questions and that. Questions, criticism, comments.